are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of baseball on MLB Network. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the LA Dodgers and the Boston Red Sox. It's Interleague Baseball next on MLB Network. At the plate, Chris Taylor, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The pitch. Takes this the other way to right. There to look it in his bets, and that's out number one. Here's Corey Seager. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Hits softly on the ground to first. Ramirez charging this one, and he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Coming to the plate now, Justin Turner, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Turner in front at 3-3.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Hit out towards second. Nunez over to his left. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Here's Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. To 2-2 now. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2. Andrew Benintendi is on deck. Lifted into the air out towards center field. Taylor is there, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. At the plate, Andrew Benintendi. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Line drive to center field, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. Now with the plate, Hanley Ramirez.
First baseman, Hanley Ramirez.
The 1-1 runs a bit inside for a ball.
Well, it's 2-1 now, and we haven't seen a fastball from him in this at bat yet. As a hitter, you've probably got to sit on that right now.
Runner. Set and the 2-1 pitch. In there, now the throw. Not in time as he steals second. In the dirt here. And over to third now is the runner. Now the 3-2 pitch.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
The 3-2 one more time. This one's down to third. Only play will be to first, as we'll see our first run score here, as this is a 1-0 ball game. Stepping in, J.D. Martinez will try and start things over now with the bases empty and two away following the RBI ground ball. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Left side. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So that'll bring in the National League rookie home run record holder, Cody Bellinger. He'll get us started in the top of the second. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Swung on and missed, outclassed by that fastball for a strike.
You know, that can really be an effective pitch to a guy that has a lot of pop. They're up there looking for a fastball up in the zone, so if you can place it a little above it, they have a hard time getting the barrel up there.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Cody Bellinger goes down to become the first out here in the second inning. Hit the other way out toward right field. Betts will wait on it, and there's the second out of the inning. Now at the plate, Matt Kemp. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. Roll right back at him, and it hit him. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first, and that'll put an end to the inning. Here's Xander Bogaerts now. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Kershaw now on 1-1. And a fastball not close. It's 2-1 now. Kershaw, a native Texan. This is his 10th season at the major league level, so almost a decade, which is quite an accomplishment.
Yeah, Matty, you ain't kidding right there. 10 years, we refer to that in the biz as hitting full pension.
Lying toward the alley in left center. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit. Now at the plate, Rafael Devers.
Batting third baseman, Rafael Devers.
A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. Started the chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. Three and two, the count for Rafael Devers. Eduardo Nunez waits on deck. The 3-2 pitch. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Standing in, Eduardo Nunez. Bogaerts leads off first with one away. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. Settling in now, Christian Vasquez. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Kershaw comes set. Here's the 1-1. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Now the 2-1 is a slider taken for a ball. Jackie Bradley Jr. would be next. Hit down the line at first, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2.
All right, 3-2 count with two outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
And the payoff pitch is chopped foul at home plate, so we'll do it again. Still 3-2. Another one sent foul. Swing and a ground ball to third. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Striding into the box, Kike Hernandez. And he'll step in to start things out against Chris Sale. Now the 3-2 pitch. And a fastball is hit on the ground towards short. Gloved by Bogarts. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So striding in, Austin Barnes. A high fastball is in there.
He's looking really great on the bump right now. I mean, it's been a while since he's allowed a base runner, and he just jumped ahead of another hitter right there.
And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. A little bouncer. That goes foul. Two strikes on him now. Lifetime against Chris Sale. The pitcher's owned him. He's a paltry 1-for-11. He's also gone down on strike. And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Here's Jackie Bradley now as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. That's lifted the other way out to left. Kemp has a read on it. One out. Digging in to try it again. Mookie Betts. It was a flyout for him to start the home first. Two and one now to the Boston leadoff hitter. Misses low here, so the count goes to 3-1. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. There's ball four. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Now we'll step off and fire to the bag. And he has to dive, but he's back in easily.
He's going, runner.
Runner goes for second. Pitch outside, the throw. And it skips in as he steals the bag easily. Betts leads off second with one gone in the inning. Hit out towards second. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. And the run will score from second to make this a 2-0 ball game. So striding forward now, Hanley Ramirez. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Here's J.D. Martinez.
Now batter.
Two out with the man at first.
J.D. Martinez.
Here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Now we'll snap one off over to the bag. Runner's back. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Digging in, Chris Taylor comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
Grounded up the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Fastball swung on and missed for the first down. Here's Corey Seager, a recipient of a National League Silver Slugger Award for his contributions at shortstop last year. 3-1 is the count to the Dodgers shortstop.
I know this team has been struggling offensively, but here's a perfect situation with a 3-1 count. You have a chance to do some damage. You know you're getting a guaranteed fastball.
Ball four.
The batter, third baseman, Justin Turner.
The 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two. Nope. Oh, it wanted that one, but it misses for ball three.
I understand pitching carefully to this guy in the box, but the man on deck doesn't represent any relief either. He's going to have to go after one of these guys.
Full count now, 3-2.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
Now the payoff pitch home, very weakly on the ground. Way and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out. Digging in for his second at-bat, Cody Bellinger. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. And the 2-1. Hit hard on the ground to second. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Ready now, Xander Bogaerts, 1-for-1 after a single this first time up.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2. That ball's headed for the gap in left center. He's got a base hit, possibly more. He'll get it into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit. Next up for the Red Sox, Rafael Devers. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Pickoff move to second, and he's back standing. Now the 1-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number two.
You chase a pitch that bad outside the zone, you got to find a way to regroup, adjust the batting gloves, only look over the heart of those 17 inches.
Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking. Into the box, Eduardo Nunez. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1. Swing and a little tapper, but it gets fouled. The 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Well, I think this is the kind of approach they need against such a prolific starter. You can't count on putting up a lot of runs, so getting him out of the game has to be the priority. Working at bats, full counts, running up the pitch count is a great way of doing that.
Bellinger is over now, and he's got it for round number two.
Catcher, Christian Vasquez.
Kershaw comes set. Here's the 1-1. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. There's a strike.
You know, I think this is a big situation in this game. They've got to lead by a couple of runs, but they don't want to look back on this inning when this one's over and think that they left some runs out there on the base path. Scoring more here would be huge.
High in the air into shallow left center. Kemp has a read on it, and that ends the inning. And now is Yasiel Puig. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. They want to get things going. How about trying to get some base runners on or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
This is line to left, but this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one.
Left fielder.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And stepping forth is the left fielder, Matt Kemp. Nope. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. 3-1 to the Dodgers left fielder. Kike Hernandez is on deck. And a fastball misses there. Ball four. Now to the plate is the Dodgers designated hitter, Kike Hernandez. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The 1-1 misses. Ball two. Ground ball foul down the left side. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out. Now batting, Austin Barnes, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at-bat. Hit the other way out toward right field. Betts has a read on it, and that's the third out. Riding in for Boston, Jackie Bradley Jr. So far 0-for-1 with a flyout. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Now stepping up to the plate, Mookie Betts.
Mookie Betts.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A fastball right over the outside corner. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. Will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. 1-1 pitch is a slider that's cut on and missed for strike two. Two outs, nobody on, but a base runner here feels like it would really change the complexion of the inning.
Yeah, Matt, that's a great point. If this two-hitter finds a way on, it really sets up the very good middle part of the order to do some damage after all.
And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. In now, Logan Forsythe. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. 1-1, here it comes. Fastball that he's way out in front of. A swing and a miss. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Chris Taylor. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. The 1-2. It is a fastball in off the plate for a ball. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. The 3-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. looking to punch him out again. The pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Betts on the run. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. Here's Corey Seager. It was a walk in his last trip. Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2.
This offense is going to have to find a way to get going. It's happened in the past. Every team goes through it where everyone seems to fall into a funk at the same time. Everyone needs to relax and not try and be the hero.
And he struck him out. So it might be time to begin the countdown as he's now gone through six innings without allowing a base hit. Here's Hanley Ramirez, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Kershaw now on 1-1. Now a swing and a ground ball, but this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Nearly a big fly to start the inning. Instead, a foul ball.
When you have two strikes on you, as a hitter, if you get something that you can handle.
Meanwhile here, this ball's given a pretty good ride out to deep left field, and that is going to clear the wall, a home run. Here's J.D. Martinez. He's grounded out and struck out in his two trips to the plate. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. A wave and a miss, a tick behind a good fastball.
He was able to sneak that fastball by him on 3-1, so now we've got a battle on our hands.
And he rings up another one, make it 9 strikeouts for him in the game. Here's Xander Bogaerts now. The 1-1 home. Popped him up. Seager backs up and takes care of it, 2 away. Stepping up now, Rafael Devers. He got called out on strikes his last time through. Now the 1-1 pitch. Popped up. Turner is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Welcome back to Fenway Park here in the great city of Boston. Red Sox on top in this one as we get set for the 7th. But first, here's a look at our game summary to this point. Stepping into the box, Justin Turner. And he'll get us started in what's officially the back third of this one.
We're moving right along into this one as we head into the late innings. Listen, if you want to score, you're going to have to bunch some hits together. And they haven't been able to do that so far. So hopefully this leadoff guy, this will be the right guy at the right spot to get something going.
And he strikes him out here. So that's out number one here in the 7th as he continues to keep him out of the hit column. There's a strike.
He's been doing a nice job out there on the mound, but the deeper you get into the game, the more the hitters have seen you. This is the part of the lineup that he has to be really careful with.
He loses him on ball 4. Ready with the 1-1. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however, and he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. So digging in now, Matt Kemp. It was a walk in his last trip. The 1-1. Strike 2 swinging.
Matt Kemp, 1-2.
On the ground, back up the box, and it'll get through into center field, a base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late. Ready for another chance? Kike Hernandez. 0-for-2 for him to this point. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw in time and the side is retired.
It's time for the traditional 7th inning stretch.
Ready for another shot now. Eduardo Nunez. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory. Another 1-2 delivery. Well, they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. So coming to the plate, Christian Vasquez. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another full count pitch home. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Kemp giving chase. Two gone. Here's Jackie Bradley now. We're in the seventh inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. And this will be nowhere close as his control deserts him here. It's a five-pitch walk.
Now batting.
Now at the plate, Mookie Betts.
Mookie Betts.
Two-one, here it is. Now the big overhand curveball makes him swing and miss. Here now the 2-2. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Kershaw comes set. 2-2 on its way home. Hit out towards second. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. That'll bring in Austin Barnes. 0-for-2 on his line thus far.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. Here now the 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Now to the plate, Logan Forsythe. He's hitless in the game, as is much of the rest of his team. Ready on 1-2. And that one just missed outside. Next pitch here will be number 100 through 7 1/3.
Man, I'd love to see a complete game. He's certainly on his way. If he can keep the number down, the pitch count down, he's got a shot at this.
Yeah, D-Row, this is every manager's dream spot right now. You're one out into the eighth inning. Your starter's giving you some good baseball, and you could go to your better relievers now towards the end of the ballgame. This is set up perfectly right now.
Hit hard on the ground towards second, and a diving effort there, but it'll come up empty. It's a base hit. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Chris Taylor. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Digging in, Corey Seager. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Still even at 2-2. The 2-2 one more time. Lifted down the line and left. On the run is Benintendi. But he can't get there, and it bounces over the wall. It's a ground rule double. Matt Barnes enters the ballgame out of the pen, looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8. Justin Turner will be his first assignment as he steps in with two men in scoring position now, but also two away. One and two, here it comes. And a good pitch, but it misses here, and that moves the count back to even on the Dodger third baseman, two and two. Outside and a full count, three and two.
Definitely in a tough situation facing the three hitter. You could work around him and maybe walk him to load the bases, but that just sets up the cleanup.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. A tag, and they get him at the plate as one run scores, but not the second. Ross Stripling is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 68, Ross Stripling.
The left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. So far, two for three in this one. And on 0-2, he misses with a fastball. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Here's Hanley Ramirez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
And hey, it was a breaking ball to boot. This guy's a pretty good off-speed hitter. You could tell by that last at-bat, he wasn't fooled at all. He sat back, waited, got the breaking ball, and didn't miss it.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch-outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Designated hitter, J.G. Martinez.
Popped him up. Barnes is under this one. And that will retire the side.
Your attention, please.
Now ninth inning safe situation coming up now as they'll entrust Craig Kimbrel with the baseball here as he'll try and close things out. Cody Bellinger will be charged with trying to start a rally in the ninth as they go to work against Kimbrel. The 1-2 is a curveball in the dirt. Full count to Bellinger, three balls, two strikes. On deck, the man they've all come to see, Yasiel Puig, waiting next. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth. In now is Yasiel Puig. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
How about it?
Digging in once again, Matt Kemp. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. Here it comes, the 3-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. And he missed with it. Ball four. So that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second. Now a swing and he pops him up. And I believe, yes, the umpire signaling for the infield fly rule. So stepping in, Austin Barnes, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. And this will be a called strike two. And trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. The Dodgers down to their final strike. And this one gets away. So now two men in scoring position. And a full house here at Fenway. 36,984 on their feet. Sent back up the middle. And that is into center field as he comes through. It's a base hit. And the second run will score as well. Digging in and looking for more, Logan Forsythe. He scored after reaching on a single in his last time up. The 1-1 is in there for strike number two. Barnes is off of first with two away. And he chased it in the dirt. Vasquez goes to get it, but no chance to recover. Forsythe is on it first after the strikeout. Ready once again, Chris Taylor. And we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home so far this inning. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And he connects with it. This one's hit deep out to left center field. And it's off the Green Monster. And the second run will score as they open things up a bit now, 6-3. Carson Smith takes over now with two gone here in the top of inning number nine.
Corey Seager.
Corey Seager will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. Hit hard to third. Devers fields it cleanly. On to first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him. Kenley Jansen takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
74, Kenley Jansen.
Here's Xander Bogaerts now. He'll lead it off against Jansen, who tries to close the door in this one.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score three runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away. Rafael Devers, the next to bat. He got under one and popped out his last time up. The 1-1 home. A ball and two strikes now. That's lifted the other way out to left. Kemp has a read on it. Two down. Into the box now. Eduardo Nunez. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Lays off his slider that time. 2-1. Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off. 3-1.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. With a three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it.
High and deep to left center field. Back goes Taylor, but he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone. Digging in now, Christian Vasquez, runner in scoring position with two gone. Vasquez. Last strike now for the Red Sox. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over. Well, sometimes that defining moment of the game is the ending. He came in and erased any hope the opposition may have had. And for that, he's our Topps player of the game.
You know, being a closer is a pressure-packed, tough job to have. So when you go out there and dominate like he just did, it's definitely worth celebrating.
Here now is our final life score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers. 6 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Red Sox, 3 runs, 6 hits, with 1 error. They left 5 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 11 minutes.